Aging has long been associated with decreasing testosterone levels, creating a host of negative effects, including decreases in strength, performance, muscle mass, declining energy levels, low confidence, and even depression. In response to this obviously undesirable situation, many men have turned to testosterone replacement therapy in recent years. This treatment uses artificial testosterone in order to rectify clinically low levels of natural testosterone production. Though this can be an effective treatment for many, it can certainly come with side effects and won't be the best option for everyone. The most concerning of these effects may be the atrophying of the testicles, the further decline in natural testosterone production, and the subsequent dependence on TRT for access to any testosterone at all. However, new information is pointing to the possibility that there may be another, more natural path for many who suffer from low testosterone. Recent studies have surprisingly shown that declining testosterone levels may not be a natural symptom of aging at all, and may instead be due to the cumulative damage of lifestyle choices and stress. Medical researcher David Handelsman found that prescriptions of testosterone replacement therapy had risen significantly in recent years due to the fact that the medical community, which before had only prescribed testosterone for pathological deficiencies, has now begun prescribing it for functional deficiencies, which are those deficiencies that arise not due to any disease or genetic abnormality, but instead arise due to lifestyle factors which can be addressed without drug interventions. In response to these findings, he conducted his now famous Healthy Man study, where Handelsman monitored the testosterone levels of 300 healthy men all over the age of 40. He found that testosterone deficiencies were far more correlated to lifestyle factors such as poor diet and obesity, and that in the healthiest participants, testosterone levels remained at healthy levels at any age. Proof of this may be found in another fascinating study, this time of the tribal Samana community of Bolivia, which lives by farming, hunting, and fishing, and consumes more calories than the average American, with no access to modern medicine. However, they still have the healthiest brains and hearts in the world, showing almost no mental decline with age, no heart disease, and remarkably, no decline in testosterone even well into advanced ages. It seems much of the functional decline in testosterone may be due to the common vices available to those living a modern lifestyle. So what is it about modern lifestyles that can lead to drastic changes in testosterone as we age? Diving through the research, I found many factors strongly correlated. The primary culprits included obesity and lack of exercise, poor diet and insulin resistance, such as seen in pre-diabetes and type 2 diabetes, lack of sleep or poor sleep quality, high levels of psychological stress, and environmental toxins such as microplastics. When you pan out and look at these factors as a whole, the big picture seems to be that they all constitute a high physiological and psychological stress load on the body. And it is well known from research that as stress hormones such as cortisol increase, anabolic hormones such as testosterone begin to decrease. Research has also shown that stress hormone production is increasing during the aging process, just as testosterone begins decreasing. However, it needs to be clear that short-term stressors are natural, handled well by the body, and can even raise testosterone. The primary example of this is exercise, which is very healthy and has been shown to increase testosterone over time. The problem seems to exclusively be with long-term or chronic stressors. Anytime you feel emotional, psychological, or physiological stress, the body produces a stress response. The sympathetic nervous system lights up and causes the adrenal glands to begin producing stress hormones to activate what is often called the fight-or-flight response. However, when this system is chronically turned on, the resulting onslaught of continuous stress hormones pushes the body beyond its limits and has even been shown to damage and shrink the hippocampus of the brain and impair adrenal function. Over time, the function of the body's stress response system continues to degrade, and as a result, general health and testosterone levels begin falling. To keep this from happening, or to begin reversing some of the damage and regain normal testosterone production, it is important to look at the lifestyle as a whole. The amount of stress from physiological, psychological, and environmental factors will need to be considered, and if needed, life changes will need to take place in order to bring these down to a healthy level. While this can often be a daunting task, there is luckily some low-hanging fruit, some easy-to-identify and address lifestyle factors that help bring testosterone production back online. First among these is the most obvious, diet and exercise. Eating more natural foods, staying away from simple sugars which promote insulin resistance, and exercising in some fashion on a regular basis have all been shown to quickly increase testosterone levels. There are also a number of beneficial supplements, such as ZMA, which is a combination of zinc, magnesium, and B6, which helps resupply the body with the nutrients needed to make testosterone in the first place, not to mention helping with sleep quality if you take it just before bedtime. And my personal favorite, adaptogenic herbs, which help the body to more easily adapt to stress of any kind, thus supporting the adrenal glands and promoting healthy testosterone production, especially for those over age 35. Some of the best adaptogenic herbs with proven beneficial effects on testosterone production include Damiana, Ashwagandha, Horny Goatweed, and Holy Basil. The adaptogenic supplement I personally use is one in which all... Next is sleep. Getting quality sleep can do wonders not only for testosterone production, but for lowering stress levels and promoting health in general. And even aside from sleep, there should be at least some time during the day allocated to resting, relaxing, or de-stressing in order to activate the parasympathetic nervous system and help restore some of the damage done by the often chronically activated sympathetic stress response. There are also plenty of powerful mental techniques to help anyone manage and lower stress levels over a lifetime. Among my favorite is the simple technique of mental reframing, where you consciously decide to frame your perspective of a given situation in a way that causes you less stress and allows you to tackle the situation with a clearer and more centered mind. There's a lot of science that went into this video, so I've provided links to the research in the description box for anyone who wants to dive deeper into the subject. I hope this video was helpful. Be sure to like and subscribe, and until next time, keep moving, my friends.